magnetic storms, and the aurora. The Earth's atmosphere often puts on a real show called aurora borealis. This field exerts a force on the particles, directing them in a circular motion around the Earth until they reach the North or South Pole region.
Following is the sound of Sputnik 1, launched by the Soviet Union in 1957. It was the Earth's first artificial satellite.
The following telemetry signals were recorded from Explorer 1, the United States' first successful Earth satellite. Launched by the Army on January 31, 1958, Explorer 1 was boosted into orbit by a Jupiter C rocket. Its most important discovery was the Van Allen radiation belts.
T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, ignition, liftoff. Lift off at 34 minutes after the hour.
The late President Dwight David Eisenhower said in 1958, "A developing space technology can provide to extend man's knowledge of the Earth, the solar system, and the universe. These opportunities reinforce my conviction that we and other nations have a great responsibility to promote the peaceful use of space and to utilize the new knowledge from space science and technology for the benefit of all mankind."
The following sound is the launch of a Delta rocket. A warning horn to clear the pad area for launch is heard just prior to liftoff. The Delta vehicle has boosted into orbit such satellites as Tyros, Echo, Explorer, and Telstar. It generates an initial thrust of over 170,000 pounds.
Communications satellite Telstar 1, developed by Bell Telephone Laboratories, was launched from Cape Canaveral on the 10th of July, 1962, by a Delta launch vehicle. The objectives were joint NASA-AT&T investigation of wideband satellite communications. Television and voice transmissions were made with complete success.
The following sound is the launch of an Atlas rocket, the vehicle that boosted four Project Mercury astronauts into Earth orbit.
Mariner 2. The 447-pound Venus probe, Mariner 2, was launched from Earth on August 27, 1962, and 109 days later flew within 21,594 miles of Venus, after a 180-million-mile curving trip. The probe of the spacecraft recorded temperatures of 800 degrees Fahrenheit at the surface of the planet. Detectors were unable to find a trace of water. Satellite relays. People in Japan had one of the most impressive events in their space activities history on July 23, 1963, when the first TV transmission over the Pacific Ocean was successfully made using Satellite Relay 1. For 20 minutes from 5:20 p.m. Japan Standard Time, TV programs, including the greeting of NASA Director James Webb and scenes of the NASA facilities, was transmitted over the Pacific from NASA ground station Goldstone to Japan.
SINCOM
3. The first TV transmission over the Pacific Ocean was made with complete success using the stationary satellite SINCOM 3. On the 10th of October, 1964, scenes of the Tokyo Olympics opening ceremony were transmitted from Kashima Station of the Radio Research Laboratory in Ibaraki Prefecture at 7350 megahertz. SINCOM 3 received and relayed to Point Magu Ground Station, 24 miles north of Los Angeles, at 1815 megahertz. 7. After taking close-up pictures of the moon's surface, Lunar Module Ranger 7 hit the target point, the Sea of Clouds, on the moon at 8:25 Eastern Standard Time on the 31st of July, 1964. More than 4,000 pictures, which Ranger 7 took, were received at Goldstone Tracking Station, California, with complete success.
The following sound is the telemetry received on Earth from the Mariner 4 spacecraft as it passed by the planet Mars on July 14, 1965. Mariner 4 sent back 22 valuable photographs of the Martian surface, as well as important data concerning the planet's environment. The following sound is the launch of a Titan II rocket, the booster for all Project Gemini missions. The liquid propellant vehicle stands approximately 110 feet high and has a diameter of 10 feet. At liftoff, its first stage generates a thrust of over 330,000 pounds.
Gemini 4. Gemini 4 was launched at 10:16 a.m. on June 3, 1965, from Cape Kennedy by a Titan II two-stage launch vehicle. After traveling about 2.7 million kilometers around the Earth, the Gemini 4 capsule re-entered the atmosphere from orbit. Apogee altitude, 290 kilometers, perigee altitude, 160 kilometers. Two astronauts, James A. McDivitt and Edward H. White, were safely recovered by the aircraft carrier WASP. During the flight, the first spacewalk by an American was made, and the extravehicular activity using the space gun provided us with the possibility of assembling and repairing spaceships in space. Gemini 6 and 7. On December 15, 1965, 11 days after the launch of Gemini 7 with two astronauts, Frank Borman and James A. Lavelle, Jr., Gemini 6 with Walter M. Schirra, Jr. and Thomas P. Stafford was launched. Both spacecraft had rendezvous experiments for 6 hours. They approached each other within 30 centimeters.
30 seconds and counting. Astronauts report it feels good. T-minus 25 seconds. 20 seconds and counting. T-minus 15 seconds. Guidance is internal. 12, 11, 10, 9. Ignition sequence start. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All engine running. Liftoff. We have a liftoff. 32 minutes past the hour. Liftoff on Apollo 11.
Roger, we got a roll.
Tower clear.
Roger, roll.
Is a most important decision that we make as a nation. But all of you have lived through the last 4 years and have seen the significance of space and the adventures in space. And no one can predict with certainty what the ultimate meaning will be of mastery of space. I believe we should go to the moon. But I think every citizen of this country, as well as the members of the Congress, should consider the matter carefully in making their judgment. We've given attention over many weeks and months.
I invited him to dinner on the 13th of August, right after you come out of quarantine. It will be a state dinner held in Los Angeles. The governors of all the 50 states will be there, the ambassadors, others from around the world and in America. And they told me that you would come too. And all I want to know, will you come? We want to honor you then.
We'll do anything you say, Mr. President.
Anytime. One question I think that all of us would like to ask, as we saw you bouncing around in that boat out there, I wonder if that wasn't the hardest part of the journey. Was that the only, did any of you get seasick?
No, we didn't, and it was one of the harder parts, but it was one of the most pleasant, we can assure you.
Yeah.
60 seconds. Lights on. Down 2.5. Forward. Forward. 40 feet down, 2.5. Picking up some dust. 30 feet, 2.5 down. Great shadow. 4 forward. 4 forward, drifting to the right a little. 1.5.
30 seconds.
Forward, just. Good. Okay. Backlight. Okay, engine stop. ACA at a descent.
Auto
descent. Control, both auto descent, engine command override off. Engine arm off. 413 is in.
That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind. For those who haven't read the plaque, we'll read the plaque that's on the front landing gear of this LAM. There's two hemispheres, one showing each of the two hemispheres of Earth. Underneath it says, "Dear men from the planet Earth, first set foot upon the moon, July 1969, AD. It came in peace for all mankind. It has the crew members' signatures and the signature of the President of the United States."
Neil and Buzz,
The President of the United States is in his office now and would like to say a few words to you. Over.
Would be an honor.
Go ahead, Mr. President. This is Houston out.
Hello, Neil and Buzz. I'm talking to you by telephone from the Oval Room at the White House. And this certainly has to be the most historic telephone call ever made. I just can't tell you how proud we all are of what you... For every American, this has to be the proudest day of our lives. And for people all over the world, I am sure they too join with America in recognizing what an immense feat this is. Because of what you have done.
Earth control auto.
Crew of Eagle going through their pre-ignition checklist.
I'm standing by for 2 minutes to go to guidance steering in the ags. Eagle Houston, you're looking good to us. Roger.
The objectives and capabilities of artificial satellites. The following man-made satellites have been launched. 1. Vanguard. OSO. Three, Nimbus. Four, Ogle. Five, Pegasus. Six, ESA. Japan's first satellite was launched from the Kagoshima Space Center in Osumi, Kyushu, on February 11, 1970. It was a test satellite launched by a Lambda 4S launch vehicle. It was Japan's first successful satellite launch.
T-minus 30. T minus 20.
10, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14,
13, 12, 11, 12.
T minus 10.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Lift it off. Let's go up.
Skylab. The Skylab project was a series of one unmanned flight and three manned flights. The object of this mission was to examine the endurance of humans under prolonged stays in space. As a result, the Conrad Kerwin and White's team spent 28 days in space, the Bean, Garriott, and Lausma team for 59 days, and Carr, Gibson, and Pogue made a record 84-day stay in space.
3 meters.
Okay, stand by.
13 meters.
1 meter.
Stand by.
10. Right here.
Contact.
Capture.
We also have capture. We have succeeded. Everything is excellent.
I'm using the power of shaking hands now. Mr. Glass.
We agree.
The Apollo-Soyuz test project. The first international collaborative manned space mission, the Apollo-Soyuz test project, became a reality July 15th when a Soviet crew of cosmonauts, Commander Leonov and his colleague Kubasov, lifted off at 9:20 p.m. Japan time. 7.5 hours later, the Apollo space station, with Commander Stafford, astronaut Slayton, and Brand on board, was launched at 4:50 a.m. Japan Standard Time, July 16th. On the 18th of July, 1 hour, 12 minutes, 30 seconds a.m. Japan time, completion of the docking occurred above the Atlantic Ocean, 660 kilometers west of the Iberia Peninsula. The docking maneuver was operated successfully.
Shalom. Hola y saludos a todos. Selamat malam hadirin sekalian.
Hello from the children of planet Earth.
Voyager. NASA's unmanned scientific satellite, Voyager 2, was successfully launched by a Titan Centaur rocket from ETR in Cape Canaveral at 10:30 Eastern Daylight Time on August 20th. The Voyager 1 unmanned space probe was also successfully launched by a Titan Centaur rocket at 8:56 Eastern Daylight Time on September 5th. Part of the scientific instruments of Voyager 2 malfunctioned during the flight, but was activated by a command from the control center. Voyager 1, having a faster trajectory than that of Voyager 2, will make its closest approach to Jupiter on March 5, 1979, and to Saturn on November 12, 1980. Voyager 2 will make its closest approach to Jupiter July 10, 1979, and to Saturn on August 27, 1981. Two Voyager spacecraft carry a copper record with aluminum jacket as a message to any extraterrestrial intelligence. This record is 12 inches in diameter and plays at 16 2/3 RPM. A needle and cartridge are provided with it.
Enterprise Houston.
Go ahead, Devo.
We have a couple of updates to your pre-flight cue card, the altitudes.
Okay, stand by one. Okay, we're ready to copy.
Separation is at 23.0. Next one, 18.0. Rolled out on final at 8.3, and then 1.9er.
Space Shuttle Orbiter, Enterprise 101. The Space Shuttle Orbiter, Enterprise 101, approach and landing tests were successfully completed at Dryden Flight Research Center, California, last year. Space Shuttle system vibration tests have been conducted at Marshall Space Flight Center, Huntsville, Alabama, since April of this year. The manned flight test is scheduled for next year. Based on the favorable results of Project Apollo and the Space Shuttle, construction of a space station would be the next possibility.
But it's really not an end, it's a beginning. It's just a small step really accomplished toward getting the orbiter into space. And then in that aspect, I'm looking forward to more of the same exciting times as we continue on toward that first orbital flight.
The father of rockets, R.H. Goddard, wrote, "I bought a number of green-covered notebooks and started to make a systematic record of suggestions. The suggestions were very diversified and concerned the possibility of using the magnetic field of the Earth, an airplane operated at high speed by the repulsion of charged particles, propulsion in space by repulsion of charged particles, the use of solar energy by light devices on a spaceship, the idea of the multiple charged rocket, the use of liquid propellants, to be opened only by an optimist." U.S. planetary probe. The United States of America has been exploring the solar system, launching the following probes or spacecraft. 1. Pioneer 5. 2. Mariner 1. 3. Mariner 2. 4. Mariner 3. 5. Mariner 4. 6. Mariner 5. 7. Mariner 6. 8. Mariner 7. 9. Mariner 8. 10. Mariner 9. 11. Pioneer 10. 12. Pioneer 11. 13. Mariner 10. 14. Viking 1. 15. Viking 2. 16. Voyager 1. 17. Voyager 2.